what's going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. In today's video, we're going to be reacting to a Marvel Studios movie trailer, and it's about all of the movies, I guess, combined that are going to be coming out over the next couple of years. They've released some sort of like teaser for it, or just teaser to promote these movies. Basically, they're releasing little tidbits and little teasers from different movies that are going to be coming out in the next couple of years. So maybe we see some Spider-Man in here. I doubt it, though, because obviously that's Sony, but we're going to see some stuff in here. It's like a little bit of a tribute, a little bit of a teaser. Let's have a look at this, shall we? With that being said, let's get straight into this trailer. 3, 2, 1, play.
I love being with people.
Oh, Stanley, okay.
It's the most incredible thing in the world.
You got to have that Stanley narration in there. Nice.
No. That world may change and evolve, but the one thing that will never change, we're all part of one big family.
We go to escape. We do. No, that's a nice touch, but no, we are Groot in there. That was nice.
That man next to you, he's your brother. That woman over there, she's your sister.
Higher, further, faster, baby.
That's right.
We're all part of one universe.
Wakanda forever!
Man, that gets me every time now. That gets me every time.
To greater glory.
God, what a universe this is, isn't it? What a universe the MCU is. Oh, that's the audience to Endgame. Opening night. Oh, God, that was such a sick moment. That Endgame moment was sick.
Avengers!
Honestly, that's an experience you'll never get again. Being in that theater, just... That was mad. Was that a cat? Oh, the... Every time this intro plays. Oh, Black Widow. This movie's gonna be sick.
But I'm done running from my past. We have unfinished business.
Who's we?
Black Widow. July 9th. Oh, so this is Shang-Chi. Here we go. This movie looks sick. September 3rd.
When you love something.
Oh, shoot. Wait, hold on. Is that Eternals? It is. November 5th. Let's go.
We're the ones who changed everything.
Oh, man. Spider-Man. Spider-Man. December 17th. Let's go. Multiverse of Madness, March 25th. Love and Thunder, May 6th. Aye. Oh, Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. July 18th, okay. July 8th. November 11th, Miss Marvel. February 17th. Guardians 3, May 5th. Fantastic Four. Let's go. We didn't get a release date for Fantastic Four, but oh well. Yo, I saw the Spider-Man logo and I panicked. I was like, I was like, yo, we better get some footage. No, we didn't. But what we did get is we got to see a lot from Black Widow, which was cool. We got a lot to see from Shang-Chi. We got something to see from Eternals. We got a first look at Eternals, which was sick. Yo, that was lit. That was a cool little tribute. Like, obviously, we're going forward. You know, past phase 3 of the MCU is kind of like, I think from now on, we're kind of going to see it as like a pre-COVID and post-COVID Marvel Cinematic Universe. I know COVID's not really a timestamp that people would want to use, but it's true because of COVID, there was that big gap in between when we got movies from phase 3 to 4. And, you know, because of COVID, Black Widow was delayed from 2019 all the way to 2021. Spider-Man's been delayed. All of the movies have been delayed. And because of that, we've had this big gap without the MCU. And now the MCU's starting to flood back in. It's almost like a new chapter. It's like a new story is coming forward. It kind of came in at the best time, really, with with Phase 4 coming in, this gap, this one long-awaited gap for the MCU kind of hit at the best time. Not saying that COVID was good or anything, COVID was terrible, but what I'm trying to say is like, we kind of needed that break from the MCU, you know? Because I feel like it's kind of got us more ramped up for Phase 4, so the fact that there was that gap, I think that helped the MCU a little bit, you know, it breathed a little bit. It helped the end of Endgame breathe a lot as well, because without that gap, I felt like if we just rushed into Phase 4, it wouldn't have allowed Endgame to have the significance it did. Because that year where we didn't have the MCU, we kind of dwelled on the MCU for a bit. We dwelled on how much we loved Endgame. We dwelled on the events of that film, and we just dwelled on the MCU as a whole, and we thought, you know, how much we miss it. You know, how much we took it for granted that these stories were coming at us about three times a year, and now that we miss it, it's all coming back, and we're all gassed as ever for it. So I think that yearly and a bit break was good for this franchise, especially since now we're getting all this content, and it's gonna be lit. So with that being said, thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the trailer as well. This was lit, man. Yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit. Take care and peace.